agriculture zone parcel. In the A1 zoning district, a commercial slaughterhouse requires a special use permit. Subject property contains an existing farm exempt agricultural structure utilized seasonally to process wild game. If approved, a new structure addition would be constructed to process livestock. The applicant estimates processing would be limited to 30 to 50 animals monthly. If approved, the facility would be required to adhere to all state and federal regulations. The 21.2 acre parcel does not contain a postal address, but is located on Brick Road, Route 657. Parcel is identified on Madison County's tax maps as 47-3B.
Yes, sir. I'll just add a few things. There's sort of two, I guess, items going on here. Two entities. We have the wild game, which is a seasonal operation, kind of like hunting season, November, December. And then you got an application here for a commercial slaughterhouse. The wild game processing, and I guess it's been there for a few years. I went out there, I know Tracy, a year ago, when this was talked about, but about a year ago, met Sean out at the site. The wild game, I guess that building, they process as wild game, was built up. Sean can talk and tell us, but several years ago, I think it didn't too long.
About 20.
20.
Yeah, it was built in 2003.
Okay, so you've been doing a wild game since then?
Yeah.
Okay. And again, I'll let Sean talk more about that, and sort of his evolution to now looking at the commercial slaughterhouse. Of course, the commercial, I would, you know, I think it's 30 to 50 a month. Yeah, let's just go ahead and say 100, if that was what it is. That to me would be very small scale. You know, 100 animals a month. Outside of the sort of hunting season, I have had some concerns with the neighbor, and I really, it's only been recently that I kind of reached out. Of course, you know, with the hearing being advertised, there are concerns. To me, the concerns seem to be more centered around the size of the wild game. Of course, again, that is by right, but there would be some limits on that operation in terms of what they can process. I don't know, and again, Sean will talk about what he's required to do with that as far as, you know, regulations from the Ag Department or federal regulations. Generally, those things are exempt from that, but again, I'll let him talk. Concerns sort of centered around, as I see it, the wild game, what's there now, or traffic, and you have Ball Top now on Thrift Road. This business, this one of wild game, just sort of appears, remember, and I've talked to Sean, other people seem to be a very successful business. When I look at the trips on Thrift Road, looking at VDOT data, annual daily trips from Wolftown Hood to the town limits is about, in 2020, on 2/2/2020, it was 120 a day. Now, I'm pretty sure they put those ropes down for like a week. And I'm not totally sure what part of that 4 mile section they put it, so that would make a big difference. But just to sort of show you, in 2015, VDOT had 110 trips per day on average on that route. So I don't see a lot of change there, but when you get to the town limits and go to Main Street, you have 300 trips. That's just a very small tenth of a mile section. 2015 at 360. So I don't know the traffic data. It doesn't seem like it picks up any major changes in the road in that time. But again, sometimes what week you do it, it could just be a fluke. But that is the concern that I'm hearing is existing operation, as far as the traffic. As far as the entrance goes, you know, I had that little back and forth just what I put with VDOT. It's a very wide entrance. I don't know if there's really a lot of improvements you can do to a rural road, a large rural entrance. I mean, there's really not a turn lane option. sight distance perspective, I don't think it's dangerous, but if it does have a, you know, if you do in those peak months of November and December have, you know, several hundred people going in and out a week, I mean, it's just going to be a lot of traffic there. So I kind of separated out with the commercial. What was proposed for this commercial side with the special use permit is for, to me, again, I would just would say that, you know, that's very small scale. It seems to be kind of minuscule compared to maybe what's going on during hunting season. So between now and April hearing, you know, I'll put together some more details and work what we kind of talked about tonight and what I've gotten from the neighbors and some of the people who have some concerns. We can look at some conditions, and whether those conditions will extend to the wild game operation, that's something that we can discuss. So other than that, that's all I have. If you have any questions for me or anybody, a question, I'll be happy to answer.
Anyone have a question for legal moments?
Well, my concern is about these conditions. I would have liked to have seen the kind of conditions that you would expect to negotiate with the applicant in this meeting rather than holding them until the joint meeting. I have no idea what those conditions are. One condition might be limiting the new operation to certain number of livestock every month. All we have at this point is an estimate of 30 to 50 per month. That doesn't strike me as a great number, so I'm inclined to agree with you. But under a special use permit, would the applicant be free to double or triple that number, absent a condition that limited them in some way. I did read the lady, the neighbors, I guess across the street neighbors, email today, and it, to me that made a lot of sense, and to tease this up, it would be helpful to know how you and the applicant are going to arrive at a proposal that you want to place before the public, and to know it at this meeting. That's all I have to say.
All right, I have a couple of questions. Number one, maybe I missed it along the way. Okay, so the deer operation, the wild game operation goes, is in place in a different building, or will it be in the same place as the new proposed one? And does that go simultaneously with the regular operation of livestock? How does that work? Because that would definitely impact the number of people going in. And I'm just curious, I don't know if it would impact them that much. That's one question.
Yeah, well, and I'll let Sean can kind of talk, but it would be two structures.
One existing,
the second one, and they would kind of work in unison. So, you know, with Sean, the new structure also would be part of the wild game as well. They would work in conjunction. As far as what Peter says, I mean, really, up until, you know, actually, I know the wild game operating has been there. That was sort of, I didn't really give it a lot of consideration until we did get the feedback that, you know, there was some concern about the size of that. The only really condition that I was going to propose was really just limiting the commercial side to, again, I just sort of set 100 per month as a condition of the special use permit. So that's why I didn't really go into an exhaustive condition. There are probably a few other things that got out of this meeting and put comments that I've gotten.
My other question or comment or whatever would be, so the special use permit is going to be established by the Board of Supervisors. Mm-hmm. We don't usually they set. I mean, we don't have to, right? We can have input, but...
I mean, you can recommend, sure,
right.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. But that's as far as it goes, as far as SUP. That is on their responsibility. So we have to say what we say and then let them decide. So they would set the numbers, they would set the other conditions that they want in the SUP, and anything else, obviously a lot more than what we have here. I would have to, it doesn't really matter about the wild game except for the numbers. That's the only reason I would have, because that's already a by-right thing. That's been successful. I was confused about the numbers, but they seem to be all over the place, and I just wish we could report on these with more accuracy if we know what that is.
Again, I got two questions. My first question is, I'm not fully understanding why we're talking about the deer processing. That's not what's being asked for here. That's already approved.
Yep.
And I don't think that should be part of this application because he's already had that approved. My second question is, I remember sitting down on that end some years ago, and Sean came in, and we gave Sean a permit to be able to operate a slaughterhouse. And I can't recall, but I know that he was here, and we gave him something, and that this doesn't cover what we gave him last time, because I remember doing this very well.
Well, maybe this would be a good time to have Sean talk a little bit about what's going on.
Yeah, unless somebody else has a question for the leader. Okay, I think that would be appropriate. Mr. Woodford, would you like to address us?
Well, going over the 50, the 30 to 50, we feel really comfortable, you know, about doing that. You know, there is a help situation, so I think that would be one thing there that I think would be very tough to get over that. As far as the question, when we do wild game, we will not be processing domestic animals when we do wild game. We're just only going to be open for roughly 40 weeks out of the year, and then once wild game is over with, we will, you know, go back into domestic animals again.
Yeah.
Just a question, did I hear you say 30 to 50 weekly or 30 to 50 monthly?
30 to 50 monthly.
Monthly.
A month,
right.
Yeah.
Just want to make sure.
I wish I was able to do that.
I would think it would be hard.
I've got a question that might be a little...
You're going to say the same thing I was going to say.
How many truckloads does that represent, 30 to 50?
That's anybody's number. I mean, you know, we have people come by and bring one. I mean, people could bring five. We actually toured a place today where a guy came and dropped off 15. Obviously, like, I can't do 15 in a day, but it varies. You know, you may have... you know, one beef, but someone may bring in 10 hogs or 5 sheep. So it's a little, you know, that one is a little up in the air and kind of out of my control.
But you're not anticipating like 40 animal trailer truck loads coming in?
No semis, nothing like that. Like, we're not capable to handle anything like that. And I don't want to do anything like that. I have no desire at all.
One question, Sean, as far as the wild game, are there any oversights from the USDA or locality? Is that just something that's just, you know, is that regulated from anyone? Or
no, like Pete was saying, we were in here, gosh, years ago, and when I first opened up, I tried to get a special, you know, to see if I needed one, and we were told we didn't need any for wild game only, and then, you know, it was something brought up years ago. And it came to the same conclusion that, and if I did need one, I would be grandfathered in, not that it would be, you know, so.
Did you happen to see the email that was circulated today by your neighbor? It struck me as supportive, but
I did, no, sir,
expressed
I did not.
Some concerns. Lincoln, do you have it?
I do.
Could you just read it?
Yeah, I mean, it just says, you know, want to know, I guess, the press release said $1,100 a year. We said 30 to 50. I mean, so
well, I guess the way that the metrics work on that, we were doing 500 over a 3-year span.
She, as I recall the email, she was concerned about the nature of Thrift Road being dangerous and not very well maintained, and concerned about cattle trucks coming in. Have you spoken with her at all about that?
I don't even know who wrote the email, so I guess that would be a no.
This email was just circulated to, actually, to just the Board of Supervisors and copied me. I circulated that to Mr. Webb and Mr. Carpenter to ask Mr. Webb to circulate it to the PC, so that just came in today.
I don't really foresee like a cattle trailer being an issue. I would personally be more concerned about people leaving the brewery half drunk, you know what I mean, and wrecking that versus, you know, a farm right there in the middle of the day or in the morning dropping off an animal. I mean, but no, so
yes. I'd like to speak to that if I could, Blue, sir. They talk about the traffic from the brewery. The traffic from the brewery is going to be 4 o'clock in the evening until dark or 10 o'clock, whatever it may be. The people are going to carry these farm animals to Shawn are going to bring them in the morning. Yeah, so the two traffics are not going to overlap each other. So far as having the dual traffic on the road, I just don't see that being a problem with the operations being at two entirely different times.
You know, our hours will be like 7:30 to 4, 7:30 to 5, or something like that, doing the domestic animals. It'd be nice to run a 24-hour crew, but, you know, that's realistic. That's not going to happen. But our hours will be from, you know, say from 7:30 to 4, whether they drop off or whether they pick up, that will still, we will have hours, you know, still 8-hour days, because the main reason is the inspector only works 8 hours a day. And if he's not there, then you can't do nothing anyway.
The other thing that concerns me a little bit, Steve, and I know that Sean has said 30 to 50, and if that's what he said, I know him well enough to know that that's what he's probably going to do. But one of the other things that I think when you start talking about putting a limit on something, let's say that the 4-H kids just had the fair, and they've sold all their livestock to all the public that supported the kids. Now they need to have it butchered. So he may have times that he may have to do a little more than that to help out the 4-H kids. And you've got Culpepper, and you've got Orange, and you've got Madison. You know, I'm all for this gentleman being able to help out the 4-H kids.
Well, I think, Sean, I mean, in our conversations, you only can do so much. I mean, you just don't have the capacity. But, I mean, that said the ad, and I was just putting it out there just to let people kind of have an idea. Did an SUP and put a limit of 100 a month. I mean, I would still consider that to be, you know, really small scale. How many, what do you estimate as far as the wild game? What do you think you're doing?
Probably 2,000.
And as far as using the facility for wild game, then going to kind of commercial, is that any? As far as USDA goes, that's no issues there, or
no. I mean, as long as we follow their guidelines, and they have very, very strict guidelines to be able to do that.
But the inspector wouldn't be there when you were doing the wild game.
No, sir. No.
But it would be otherwise. The inspector would have a
yes. The 40 bunch that we are doing, you know, processing, they will be there.
When you talk about wild game, is that primarily deer or exclusively deer?
It's primarily deer. We do some bear, some wild game. I mean, some wild boars. Well, not many, but we do some. But primarily deer.
And I gather that's a seasonal business.
Right? Yes, sir. Yeah. Last year that they started early season, comes in September. That didn't really pan out very well. But generally, archer season comes in first Saturday in October, and it goes out the first Saturday in January. Most likely, we would try to run domestic up until November, because that's when you really get busy. But we will probably try to do domestic at least 3 days a week, what, you know, when archery season's in. But then once November comes, we won't do domestic at all.
And for wild game, particularly for deer, you're talking about somebody bringing the deer up in a pickup.
And I, to my knowledge, there's never been an accident that anybody coming from my shop has ever been involved in.
Now, since we brought up the email, just the last question that I believe was on that was about retail sales. Mm-hmm. And that would be addressed. I think you already are having USDA inspection, right?
Yes.
So retail sales would be addressed in the SUV. You don't plan retail sales, I assume.
You know, that's a dream of mine, and we're so far from that that it's pathetic. Like, I would love to be able to do it, but I don't see it being profitable where we're at now, just because we have so many other things going on. But hopefully, I can revisit that in the coming years or so.
The retail would be off-site somewhere.
That's correct. Yes, sir. That's why we had another plan.
Any other questions for Ms. Woodford? I think I mispronounced your name, Woodford.
Woodford.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
I just have a request for Ligon that if you do negotiate conditions, it would be helpful to send them out in advance of the joint meeting.
Yeah, I'll actually have to have something worked up by next Friday because I'm off the weekend for that. So the packet will go out. There's plenty of time for you to review it and think about it. That next Friday will when we'll go out. So.
Okay. If I'm understanding you correctly, the concerns about these large numbers that someone mentioned per year, which you said you can't do, you're basically telling us that the size of the facility and the staffing issues would prohibit you from being able to do.
Oh yeah, and I'm not building my facility to do 100 animals a month. Right. I'm building to do 50 animals a month.
Yeah. So the questions that were being raised about. Some large number.
I can see how on that was mystery. I would love to be able to do that many, but that's realistic. That's not going to happen. It's not even possible. I mean, it's not possible.
But my inclination is to say that no more than 100 in a month.
And the other point I have is, if you think about this, you're probably talking about, on average, one trip a day. If you have 30 a month, you're not going to have 100 cars a day or 100 trucks a day come in.
There's no way.
The traffic is not a huge issue either.
You know, it's some places on our road, it gets tight because, you know, the ditches I walked out. Right. We not just hadn't done, but that's mainly going on thrift towards town, not so much coming. And most people come from 230 away because the other way it's just so hurting.
Right. I'm not sure everybody realizes that they keep saying Thrift Road, but your entrance is actually on the end of Ridge Road.
Yes, sir, that is correct. Yeah.
And that Thrift Road then goes directly over to the road. Mm-hmm. Any other questions or comments?
Just one comment. I've mentioned this email that your neighbor sent. And as I said, it was supportive of your application, but I think it would be helpful if you would get it from Ligon.
Yeah, absolutely.
And talk to the lady about it.
And we'll obviously I'll meet with Sean this week and we'll sit down and take this feedback and try to come up with something for the next joint meeting as far as conditions that we can present.
Okay. Any other questions or concerns from you? Well, we need the comments from the public.
That was a big deal for the governor. Our second only APA grant awarded to Madison County and this administration's first APA grant. So the state, not just Madison County, but the state is very excited about this project, and we are agriculture, so it's not going to be unusual to run into people with agricultural products on any of our roads.
Thank you. any other comments from the public?
I do.
Okay.
Very short, my name is Mike Fisher. Don't make no difference, I can talk loud enough. I'm from Unova, Virginia, and I just say that God knows we need this in Madison County. Takes months to get a hog or cow butchered. Talk here is almost a year. Wait, you better be quick to get it. So the only other one I know of is in Front Water. So there are other folks coming on. There's one in Orange. But the capacity, I mean, we could have 10 of these, and you still have the need for them. Thank you.
Any other comments from the public? Comments or questions from the planning commission? Okay, thank you. Okay, we have also an anticipated